traditional dollar that my great granddaddy was given. My great granddaddy gave a dollar in church. Here it is, 70 years later, us still giving a dollar and think we doing something. It costs more than a dollar to burn the lights. It costs more than a dollar to clean the carpet. It costs you money just to dump your garbage right now. City of Chicago, nothing remains the same. Amen. And the bottom line, all I'm simply saying is we got to move beyond tradition and we got to get anchored to the word of God. What works in grandmama's day, even in my mom and daddy's day, ain't gonna work now. Amen. The church does not belong to us, it belongs to God. I remember as a child, amen, when the church in the north was in its formative stages, amen, how we would sell chicken dinners, barbecue dinners, pig feet, pig ears, amen, all that stuff, amen. And I remember on Saturdays when the church was having these dinners, our job, amen, was to deliver. Amen, somebody. Amen. So-and-so done ordered three and four dinners. Our job was to take them there. That was our job as children. Amen. But don't you know the church was not built on selling dinners? Amen, amen, somebody. The church was not built on barbecue dinners. The church is supported by tithes and
offerings.
Come on here, somebody. Well, Reverend, that's Old Testament. Once again, show me in the New Testament where Jesus dismissed tithes and offerings. He said, I came not to destroy, but to fulfill. Right now, more is expected from us on the grace and mercy than that 10%. Hallelujah. Amen. More is respected right now out of the more than the 10%. Amen. So my sisters and brothers, when we talk about building victorious people on the word of God, the responsibility of the preacher is not simply just showing up on a Sunday. Amen. Standing before God's people hoopering and hollering and not really saying anything. Amen. It's more than taking a tune. Amen. You know, don't you know unsaved folks can preach? Amen. Don't you know the devil can preach? Amen. The devil knows the word of God. He misquotes it. Amen. But he knows the word of God. The devil can sing. Come on here, somebody. He got his start in the choir. Amen. You think you something because you lead the song? Amen. Folks stand up. Amen. The devil did that. Amen. The devil got beside himself because he thought he was as great as God. He had a host mind. Amen. But he still could not compete with God. Hallelujah. Amen. But we have a responsibility. It's more than a hoop and a holler. Amen. It's much more than that. It's more than standing up before people on a Sunday. Amen. And 6 days out of the week not doing nothing else. Amen. It's much deeper than that. Amen. There's a ministry that must go forth. Now, the preacher in your subject, amen, when it talks about building victorious people on the word of God. Amen. The Bible says, come as you are. Whosoever will, let them come. Amen. How many bench members in the house? Bench members. Amen. I hear one that's honest. Amen. 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 One that's honest. There's a special blessing just for being honest. Amen. Special blessing. Amen. Amen. But let me help somebody there. The Bible says, amen, whosoever will, let them come. But he doesn't tell you to stay as you are. Amen. Too many folks come to church. I don't want to do anything. But God has empowered each one of us. Amen. Come on here, 1 Corinthians chapter 12. It talks about being in the body of Christ. Amen. Amen. And some folks jump up and say, I want to be a preacher. What does God say? Have you consulted God? Amen. It's not about what you want to be. It's what God has already designed for you to be. In the body of Christ, God places us in his body where he wants us to be. I'm going to tell you something. Amen. I never sought to be a pastor. I never sought to want to preach. I never sought it. Amen. But it was ingrained in me before I got here. I knew I was going to preach. Amen. I just did not know when and where. But ever since I was a child, amen, before I went to school, I knew I was going to preach. Amen. Amen. It has to be in you already. It's not something that you seek on your own. Because if you think you can seek it, it's a sign that you're not called. Amen. Amen. Because if the calling is there, it don't matter what you do and where you go. You can't smoke it out. You can't burn it out. You can't shoot it out. You can't drink it out. Amen. If it's in you, it's coming out. And you don't need a pulpit on Sunday to stand up and preach. If God calls you, you'll be right there on 107th Street. You'll be preaching to the gangbangers right there. That the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life. Call is genuine, but the call must be genuine. And so my sisters and brothers, the preacher has a task. Amen. And that's why we have to pray for our pastors. We have to pray for our preachers, because what he has to do, according to your text and your subject, building victorious people on the word of God. Amen. Since we don't come to become bench members, since we don't come just to sit in the pews Sunday after Sunday, that must mean we come to work. Amen. That means that we must come to submit ourselves to the authoritative figure. Amen. Always beware of this, pastor. Amen. You're going to always have those there, amen, who's going to argue on what the word says. Amen. The Bible does make reference to the pastor being the angel. Amen. But some folks have a problem with it. I don't have a problem with it. Because I ain't got no heaven. I don't have no hell. The only thing I'm concerned about is doing what God called me to do. You may have a problem with him being called the angel of this house. It ain't my